to my channel. My today's recipe is chicken ghee roast. This is a recipe which originated in Mangalore in a small village in Kundapur. This chicken has a very spicy and tangy flavors to it, which will make you crave for more. So without any delays, let's look into the ingredient list now. We'll start off preparing chicken ghee roast by marinating our chicken. For that, today I am using a kilo of chicken drumsticks. But you can use a whole chicken cut into curry pieces also. 1 cup of plain Greek yogurt, 1 tablespoon of garlic paste, 1 tablespoon of ginger paste, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 2 teaspoons of red chili powder, and some salt, of course, according to taste. So these are the few basic ingredients we are going to marinate the chicken with. So I'll add in the yogurt along with the ginger garlic paste and the powdered spices and mix all the ingredients well along with the chicken pieces. After mixing it well, now I'm going to cling wrap it and let it rest for 2 hours before I start preparing the ghee roast out of it. Along with our marinated chicken, we need a few more ingredients to prepare the ghee roast. So here I have around 6 to 7 dry red chilies, but these red chilies are not very spicy. Next, I have 2 teaspoons of coriander seed, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1/4 teaspoon of fenugreek seeds, 1 teaspoon of black peppercorns, and 1 teaspoon of fennel seeds. I'm basically going to dry roast the chilies and this whole spices and make a paste out of it. Next, I need some curry leaves, about 20 to 25. 1 onion finely chopped, 1 teaspoon of brown sugar. Traditionally, gur or jaggery is used. If you have jaggery, then go for it. Otherwise, you can use brown sugar also. About 7 to 8 cloves of garlic. And here I have tamarind pulp. Basically, I have taken the tamarind and soaked it in some water. And now I'm going to strain it before I use it. And as the name of this recipe suggests, it is cooked in ghee and we'll need about 4 to 5 tablespoons of ghee. So we'll start off by roasting our spices. For that, I'm going to add in the chilies first. Dry roast them for about a minute or two, or till the aroma of the spices are released and they soften down a bit. It's been around 2 minutes now, and the chilies have started releasing the aroma, and now I'm going to directly transfer it to a grinding jar. After removing the dry red chilies, I'm going to add in the whole spices now, all in one go, and I'm going to again dry roast them for another minute or till the aroma starts releasing from the spices. You have to be very careful and keep on stirring so that the spices don't burn. After cooking the spices for a minute, as you can see, they have turned a little brownish in color, and this is exactly what we want. We'll allow it to cool down a bit, and after that I'm going to transfer it into the grinding jar. Along with the roasted spices, I'm going to add in the whole cloves, and along with it I'm going to add in the tamarind pulp. I'll add in about half to one fourth cup of water to grind my spices. And this is the texture we want in our grinded spice for the ghee roast. So let's start preparing ghee roast. For that, I'm going to add in about 4 tablespoons of ghee or clarified butter. Be generous with the amount of ghee in this recipe. Next, I'm going to add in the chopped onions to it. We'll cook the onions for about 3 to 4 minutes till it starts turning slightly brownish in color. It's been about 4 minutes now, and as you can see, the onions have started turning brownish in color. At this stage, I'm going to start adding in the chicken pieces to it, rather the marinated chicken pieces. Adding onions to this recipe is completely optional, but somehow I prefer the taste of onions in this. After adding the chicken pieces, I'll also add in the rest of the marinade ingredient and mix the, or rather stirring the chicken pieces and cook them on medium flame. Keep stirring in your chicken pieces. Cook them well from all sides. After cooking it like this for 5 minutes, I'm going to add in the grinded spices. It's been about 3 minutes now and I'm going to add in the grinded spice mixture and mix the spices well along with the chicken pieces. And at this point I have also turned my gas to low sim and we are going to cook it like this till the chicken is completely done. You need to keep on stirring your chicken pieces so that they don't stick to the bottom of the pan. And if you have noticed, I didn't add in any water. The water that has come out is mainly from the chicken. It's been about 10 minutes now and as you can see, the ghee has surfaced out. And my chicken pieces are also well cooked. They are basically falling apart now. At this point, I'm going to add in the brown sugar. This adds to the tangy and the sweet flavors of the chicken. The sugar actually adds as a great flavoring agent for this chicken with the hot spices and the tangy tamarind. And finally, I'm going to add in the curry leaves. Another very flavoring agent for this chicken. We'll cook this for another 2-3 minutes and our chicken is ready to be served. It's been another 2 minutes now and I'm going to switch off the gas. My chicken ghee roast is ready and I'm going to serve it now. Is ready. You can serve it as a starter or as a side dish with any kind of naan roti, paratha, even some rice dishes. So do try it in your kitchen and I'm going to end this video here. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you for watching.